Indian Army trains for uncertainty in almost every single way. Adventure, my fellows from the Army Adventure Wing are here, Colonel Vishal Chopra, Colonel Sachin Nikam, Colonel Rajneesh. Exceptional men in land, sea, air. These men know that there would be a time when all that they've ever learned would not work. But what would work is the very foundation that is given in the psyche of every single army man. Ladies and gentlemen, I thank the August House, the venerable members here, and it's an honor, the greatest honor for any soldier to speak when the chief is the chief guest. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much. Jai Hind.
I request Dr. Pradeep Bharadwaj to please take over the proceeding.
Chief of Army General Bipin Rawat Sahab, सबसे पहले झुककर सलाम करते हैं हम आपको कि आप यहां पर आए और इस कार्यक्रम की गरिमा बढ़ाई। जब हम 1 नवंबर को जन साहब के ऑफिस में मिले तो हमने उसी दिन डिसाइड कर दिया था कि हमारा चीफ गेस्ट होगा तो चीफ ऑफ आर्मी होगा। आप देखिए हमारे प्रोग्राम में बहुत सारे नेता आए हैं, वो सब नीचे हैं। हमारे चीफ ऑफ आर्मी द रियल हीरो ऑफ द नेशन सबसे ऊपर। सिक्स सिग्मा एक ऐसी प्राइवेट कंपनी है, हम गवर्नमेंट नहीं है, प्राइवेट कंपनी है जो सेना का दिल से सम्मान करती है, सेना के साथ मिलकर काम करती है। और सेना अध्यक्ष जनरल बिपिन रावत लीग से हट करके हमको सिविलियन डॉक्टर्स को ट्रेनिंग देते हैं हाई ऑल्टीट्यूड वॉरफेयर स्कूल के अंदर, जहां पर जाकर जहां पर ट्रेनिंग करके हम लोग 40,000 लोगों की मेडिकल सर्विस करते हैं केदारनाथ में, बद्रीनाथ में और हेमकुंड साहिब में। जनरल साहब जैसा मैंने आपको बताया था मॉर्निंग में, वो शेर है जिन्होंने पाकिस्तान को घुस के अंदर घुस के मारा है। आपका बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद जनरल साहब। और अभी हम चाहते हैं कि आप हमारे कुछ लोग जो कि हाई ऑल्टीट्यूड में जिन्होंने अच्छा काम किया है उनको आप सम्मानित करें, और कुछ अवॉर्डीज हैं हमारे उनको आप सम्मानित करें। आई विल गिव टू गगन।
कैन यू प्लीज हैव द अवॉर्डीज ऑफ द गोल्डन मेडल, द हाई ऑल्टीट्यूड गोल्डन मेडल।
मैं जनरल बिपिन रावत साहब से रिक्वेस्ट करूंगा कि वे अपने विचार व्यक्त करें इस लीडरशिप समिट में। जनरल बिपिन रावत साहब। प्लीज बी सीटेड, आप बैठ जाइए। प्लीज रिक्वेस्ट है आपसे सबसे।
And all those associated with Six Sigma Healthcare, Honorary Captain Bana Singh Paramveer Chakra, Uttar Major Yogendra Yadav, Paramveer Chakra, other distinguished and disabled war veterans from the Indian Armed Forces Fraternity, all the eminent personalities and dignitaries present here for this leadership summit, ladies, gentlemen, and the media. I feel indeed honored and privileged to be here amidst you on this leadership summit. Six Sigma Healthcare has decided to honor some of the very distinguished and brave veterans from the Armed Forces Fraternity and those from Six Sigma Healthcare who have provided human service to humanity. Our association with Six Sigma Healthcare has been in providing support through training to their medical doctors, medicos, other people associated with them to be able to reach out to the high altitude areas, whether it is in Kedarnath, Mansarovar, or any other such places where our citizens visit these areas and require specialized medical care. Today, as I stand here on this cold winter morning, most of us are tired in coats and jackets, some with mufflers around their necks, caps on the heads. I wish to pay reverence to my soldiers who stand steadfast in this cold on the high altitude terrain of the Saltoro Ridge manning this Siachen Glacier. Those who are deployed in the icy heights of Mashko, Kargil and Draz. Those who are manning posts along the line of control in the Gurez, Kiran, Machal, Kandahar, Lipa Valley, Uri, Doda sectors, where temperatures today are ranging between minus 10 and minus 45 degrees Celsius. My heart also goes to those brave soldiers who are sitting in the eastern portion of Ladakh, an area which is devoid of snow because of the very high winds that blow in the area, which does not allow the snow to set in. But the wind chill factor takes the temperature to as low as minus 50 degrees Celsius. My heart also goes to those people manning the borders along the HP Tibet, UP Tibet borders in the autonomous region of Tibet. To those people who sit on the icy heights of the Tawang tract of Arunachal Pradesh, along the Siang Subansiri valleys, sitting at sub-zero temperatures. Six Sigma, therefore, gets naturally associated with us because of our soldiers who are sitting at these icy heights need proper health care. It is difficult to comprehend what these officers and men go through while sitting and manning these posts. You remain in ice igloos for as much as 6 to 7 months in a year. There is no source of entertainment. You get caught in blizzards for as long as 10 to 15 days in a month. Diseases like pulmonary edema, snow blindness, and many other associated diseases from chilblain to frostbites, and I can continue naming the kind of diseases that one can suffer or ailments that one can suffer at these altitudes. Yet, the soldier never hesitates to go to these icy heights. In fact, the number of volunteers that time and again come forward to repeatedly serve at these icy heights, in fact, puts challenges on us as to how often can we keep putting them there, at times even against medical advice. Hemoglobin becomes erratic. The oxygen content at these heights is less than 20%. Yet their bodies have to be attuned to serving and manning these posts. So when we talk of leadership, ladies and gentlemen, qualities of leadership are present in every soldier of the Indian Army or the Indian Defence Forces. We as officers get commissioned after training at the pre-commission academies, be it the Indian Military Academy, Officers Training Academy and what have you. And finally get commissioned with pips on our shoulders. Our soldiers respect us because we carry weight on our soldiers on our shoulders by virtue of our rank. They obey, maintain discipline. But thereafter begins the life of officering them and displaying qualities of leadership. Because your soldier will only respect you if you know that you are worth leading them. Leading them in combat, leading them whenever the situation so arises. In the armed forces, we don't say you move and I follow. Our dictum is, follow me. The leader leads and his command then follows. This is what leadership in the armed forces is all about. Today again, once I stand in front of you, I cannot but forget some of the daring deeds of our soldiers. Prominent among them is sitting here, Honorary Captain Bana Singh. Who undaringly led the assault on Pakistan's care post in the northern glaciers of Siachen. Captured that post, and that post has rightly and very proudly been named as the Bana Post. These, ladies and gentlemen, are the leaders of the Indian Armed Forces. Subedar Major Yogendra Yadav. His feats at the Kargil battle in 1999 are well known to all of you. I don't want to keep repeating that. These are soldiers who have braved against all odds, displaying qualities of leadership. Was he an officer? Was he a JCO then? No, he was just a normal Jawan. Yet he displayed qualities of leadership that every one of us would envy. Who would not like to be in his boots? But it's not an easy task. At the same time, such opportunities do not come by the way of everybody. All of us would like to get such opportunities, but do not get. Some of us who do get these opportunities stand out, like Subedar Major Yogendra Yadav. I salute that personality. Ladies and gentlemen, leadership is all about leading. Therefore, what is so complex about leadership, if it is all about leading? Because when you move forward, everybody follows. It is not that simple. It appears simple, but it's a very complex phenomenon. Even amongst a crowd, you find leaders emerge. But leaders are those who lead people in the right direction. Leaders are not those who lead people in inappropriate directions. As we are witnessing in a large number of university and college students, the way they are leading masses of crowds to carry out arson and violence in our cities and towns. This is not leadership. A leader is one person who leads you in the correct direction, gives you the right advice, and then ensures that you care for the people you lead. So leadership is through personal example. And that is what we in the armed forces are proud of. Each and every leader in the Indian Army or the Indian Defence Forces has proven his worth as a leader. And that is what I think makes us stand out amongst our people. I am indeed very grateful to Six Sigma Healthcare for having given me this opportunity to be present amongst you, to share my thoughts with you, and above all, honor some of the brave and gallant soldiers who have not hesitated in paying with their life for the honor of our nation, for the honor of the armed forces, and for the honor of the unit. And that is why the five words or principles on which Indian Army operates is Naam, Namak, Nishan, Wafadari or Izzat. It is these five words that are so deeply ingrained in the hearts and minds of every soldier. And I do recall my days at the Training Academy, at the National Defence Academy, Pune, and subsequently at the Indian Military Academy as a young gentleman cadet. You know, we had our ustads who taught us drill, who disciplined us. We had our instructors who taught us physical training. We had our instructors who taught us tactical training. We had teachers who taught us military history and inculcated leadership qualities in us. But all of them always reminded us of one thing. Whenever we committed a mistake or we went astray, all these people said, kya meri bejti karayega kya? Aur saath mein kya apni bhi bejti karayega? This word bejti is what has got ingrained in the hearts and minds of every officer who's passed out on the portals of our pre-training academies. It is because of this few words of wisdom that our instructors taught us, our ustads taught us, bejati. And therefore, I think every soldier, every leader is concerned about the ijjat of the armed forces. Anybody who goes astray and does not maintain the izzat that is expected to, finds no place in our service, and we do not hesitate in getting rid of those people. These are few and far between, but we do not ever hesitate in getting rid of those people who do not believe in maintaining their izzat, the izzat of the organization, of the army, and the flag which they are determined to serve. So with that, ladies and gentlemen, I am indeed honored and privileged to be here amidst you. Thank you, Six Sigma Healthcare, for giving me this opportunity. And thank you all for a patient hearing. Jai Hind. Dhanyavaad.
Thank you, Dr. Sam. We are thrilled to have you. I request our Board of Management Chairman, Dr. Kirat Solanki, to please on the stage. Dr. D.S. Rana, Air Marshal Pawan Kapoor Saab, please on the stage. And now I invite the DGMS Army, DGMS Navy, and DGMS Air Force to please on the stage for an honor from Six Sigma Healthcare. Yes, we have a moment, please. I request General Bipin Rawat to honor our DGMS Army with the memento of Six Sigma Healthcare. I also request Additional DG Devi. Please. Additional DG, DGMS Devi. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you. Now, we will honor the group two. Please be ready and be fast. Yes, group two, please.
I would request all the awardees to kindly accumulate near the stage, all the group two awardees. Let's start with the award for best hospital of the year, surgery and IVF. Sirsa, Haryana goes to Apex Hospital and Research Center, Sirsa.
आपको भाग के आ रहा है, दौड़ लगा के आ रहा है, चीफ रियल हीरो ऑफ द नेशन. Oxygen hospital. Yes, baby, the oxygen.
Excuse me, sir. Okay.
Bipin Rawat from Kolkata, West Bengal.
Thank you.